What's up, everybody? We are Board Game Burger, and this is Taste Test, our format where we take a more in-depth look at a game, show you some buttery shots of that game, and tell you whether it's worth plating up and serving to your friends or not. So, let's talk about a title I was super excited about in our top 10, Gutenberg. The printing press was central in the turning of the tides of the Middle Ages, making the sharing of information faster and more efficient. In other words, the internet of the day, if you will. But with books and ink and the smells of mahogany, this invention has also opened up a new line of business, and in Gutenberg, players are trying to snag their piece of the pie in the printing industry. You will be starting a new press, upgrading that press, turning those gears, and fulfilling orders. As usual, the player with the most points at the end of the game wins. The game takes place over 6 rounds in 5 phases. Phase 1. Turn those gears clockwise so that the next section lines up with the white line on your player board. So satisfying to see those gears turn. Next we have the planning phase. Hide your board using the screen that doubles as a player aid. Nice! Then, take the initiative markers and place them on the actions you would like to do, putting more cubes on the slot of the action you would like to do the most. When all players have finished their planning, move on to the next phase. Execute those plans. The player with the most cubes on an action goes first, and player order breaks all ties. Actions are resolved following the player board and the main board from top to bottom. You can take orders. To do so, take one printing card of your choice and one refinement card of your choice to combine them and make one order and add it to your player board. You can have a maximum of 4 orders on your player board at a time. The next action is take inks. Select a row of inks and you can take what's there. If there is no cost above the ink, it's free. Otherwise, you pay the cost. You must take inks in order from left to right, no skipping. Next, you can develop specialties such as typesetting, woodcutting, binding, and illuminating. Players doing this action take the card from the board and develop the specialties listed on the card, or any one specialty of their choice. If your specialties reach a certain level, you gain stuff from the reward token. More stuff is always cool. Then players have a chance to improve their printing houses. Take one of the available gears and add it to your player board in the topmost space. These gears have abilities that can be activated once per round. The active ability is lined up with a white line on the player board. Optionally, you can, instead of taking the gear from the main board, use this action to reposition a gear you already own. You can only have 3 gears on your board, so if you get a new one, you can discard one of the old ones to make room. Next, there's a patron action. Here, you place one of your cubes on the selected reward, blocking that spot for other players, or take a patron card, paying the required cost or having achieved the required prerequisites. Each patron card you have at the end of the game is worth 8 points. Woohoo! Now that all the available actions on the board are finished, it's time for phase 4. Fulfill those orders. You can fulfill as many orders as you can afford. Orders are broken up into 2 cards, the printing card and the refinement cards. You must complete the printing card with the correct types, but the refinement cards are optional and provide extra bonuses. Types and specialties are never lost when paying or fulfilling an order, but types can only be used for 1 order in each round. You can purchase types at any time during the game, and the cost is equal to how many types you have plus 1. So if you own 3 types, the next one will cost you 4. Phase 5. Prepare for the next round. Discard all the leftovers on the main board except for the patron cards and refill all the spots on the main board. Note, during the action phase, nothing is refilled, so doing an action first is a big deal. At the end of 6 rounds, players count up points for specialty levels, patron cards, and extra money. Gutenberg is a strategic game between family and advanced weight. The game isn't difficult to learn, and the rulebook is excellently written. There's even some info about the origin of the printing press and biographies for the characters. Boom! Bang! Learning things, made fun. Huge props for the excellent rulebook, seriously. The components are decent, the types are awesome, and the boards are double layer. The production quality not only matches the price point, but exceeds it. The only thing that would make it over the top would be metal coins and gears. Speaking of those gears, I love how simple and effective the gears are. It's so creative and original. As for the gameplay, it's just as clever as the component design. The action selection in this game is extremely interesting because each player has a different number of black cubes. The first player has the least amount, and each player has one more than the previous player. Such a great solution in balancing, as the first player wins all ties when determining who goes first. But if the second player is tied with the third player, the second player wins. That combined with the fact that once actions and resources are taken from the main board and not refilled until the next round gives the game an interesting cross between action selection and worker placement feel. Most of all, I really enjoy the bacon added to this burger. The gears give a small engine or chain to help gain resources and maximize points when fulfilling orders. Gutenberg is also a game I wouldn't even hesitate to teach new gamers to get them deeper into this awesome hobby. This is absolutely a game I recommend to everyone. It's even got an automa if you're into solo play. But seriously, if you like games with action selection, great components, engine building, fulfilling orders, and delicious historical themes, this game is for you. Gutenberg not only has a solid spot on my shelf, but it easily receives the Board Game Burger Recommends Award. The flavor profile of this game just hits all the things my palate enjoys. I mean, just look at the ingenious way they organize the inside of the box. This is a game that I didn't know much about whenever I picked up the copy and was absolutely pleasantly surprised. So go out, get yourself a copy, do all the subscribey things, check out our Patreon, and as always, stay hungry for more board games, my friends.